Hello everyone. Welcome to my channel, Meditating Human. I am Tiffany and I will be your host through this thing we call life. Today I wanted to speak about, are you ready for your blessing? Asking that question, are you ready for your blessing? That's a question we need to ask ourselves on a daily basis. You know, a lot of people, and I still have to check myself. A lot of people are wanting a lot of stuff. You should absolutely have goals and aspirations, but what are you doing to obtain that? You know, and then we go back to inspired action. It's more than just the thought. You have to put action behind that. You're wanting a mate, a husband, a wife. What are you doing to prepare yourself for that person, that new person in your life, for that type of commitment? You know, a lot of us, including myself, you know, we say, okay, you know what? I'll do that when I get the thing. I'll do that when the time comes. When that thing actually happens, then I'll change. Then I will, you know, be a little bit more open, cook every day. I would, you know, whatever it is that you would need to do to maintain that opportunity, right? Whatever it is you would need to do, a lot of us say, well, when it comes, then I'll do that. But when you look at it from that perspective, I promise you it will never come because you're waiting on it. Meanwhile, it's waiting on you. Prove to me, it's saying, prove to me that you want me, that you're ready for me, that when I show up, you're going to take care of me. You're not proving anything to anyone by waiting, chilling out in the cut, waiting for a thing to show up. Because more often than not, if by some miracle it happens, we often lose it because we didn't practice. We don't know how to take care of it. That time between wanting a thing and that time between wanting a thing and that thing actually manifesting, so pulling that thing from the etheric into the material, that's your time to practice for that thing. Oh, I want this new job, but I have to, you know, I have to wear a suit. My current job, I don't have to wear a suit. Yeah, well, wear a suit every day. If you can afford to go buy a suit, go buy a suit or two and wear the suit. Wear the suits to work. You're practicing for the life you want to lead, that for the life you are going to lead, for the job you are going to have. You know, I've come across people that they're like, you know, I would like a luxury vehicle. So they'll want a Mercedes or a BMW or something. I want a luxury vehicle, but I can't afford that. And I'm just like, well, why can't you afford that? I'm like, you are driving a brand new car right now. You could actually have had a luxury vehicle. It would have been pre-owned and it may not have been the latest model. But it's a step in the right direction. It puts you in the car, it puts you in the energy, and the next one most likely will be a brand new whatever it is. A lot of people don't see it that way. They're just gonna wait, and you will continue to wait. And people wonder why, when they sit and they wait, the thing that they want doesn't manifest. Even if the blessing came to you tomorrow, what would you do with it? You would have no plan, you would have no clue, and that opportunity, as fast as you got it, will be as fast as you lose it. Because that's what happens when we don't plan, when we don't practice for this opportunity to come. Instead of waiting and saying, you know, woe is me, this is not here, you know, I really want this thing, but it's not here. You say, okay, yeah, I want this thing and this is my plan on how to get it and this is how I am executing that plan. You know, I was in Barnes & Noble the other day and I had just random conversation And the guy, he was saying, you know, I was saying, you know, we would talk about like kind of working in offices, and I'm like, I can't do that. I just don't have the fortitude for that. I can't do that. I need, you know, I'm like working for myself and doing things for myself or whatever. And he's like, oh, that's so fantastic. He, because of what he does, he needs to be in person. And so we were just speaking, and we were talking about future plans, future planning. And, you know, I was like, you know, this is what I want to do. And he's like, well, at the end of the whole conversation, he's like, well, what are you doing in order to get to that point? And I said, well, this is what I'm doing. And I rattled down a laundry list of all the things that I'm doing, some things I'm actually doing, other things I am looking into the research, other things I am just now putting together the idea. So I am in, depending on what it is, I am in various stages of planning. But the point to that is that I was just able to rattle off, this is exactly what I'm doing in order to get from point A to point B. That's how prepared you should be for when the opportunity comes. If I sit and I have a conversation with you, and just to backtrack really quickly, I'm so happy he asked me that, because it put me to the test. Because if I got stuck and I couldn't rattle off exactly what my plans were in order to get from point A to point B, then I would know that I need to go back and I would need to re-examine that. I would need to re-examine how much I really wanted a thing, how well I've planned for the receiving of that thing. But if I ask you, what do you want? You say, this is what I want. Well, what are you doing to get that? You should be able to rattle off a list. Good question, Tiffany. These are the things that I am doing to get that. Well, where are you in the planning stages? Like, what have you done so far? Well, I've done this. I'm still planning on this. I'm doing a little bit more research on that because I'm kind of not sure. I have these ideas, but right now they're on the back burner because blah, 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 blah. But I'm executing on this, this, and this right now. And based on the success of the execution of these three items, then I move forward with this one because it's dependent on that. You know, you come at it from a planning perspective. The thing that separates a dream from a goal is the planning. And once you start planning, that dream then becomes a goal. And that planning breaks down that big old giant unobtainable, what you would think is an unobtainable goal. What that does, it breaks it down into these bite-sized chunks that you can deal with, that you can process, that you can execute on. And by the time you turn around, that big goal that you had has been met by breaking it down into these smaller goals, into these smaller milestones, into these milestones, right? So you have a plan, and within that plan, there are milestones. And as you accomplish each milestone, you've accomplished that plan, you've accomplished that goal, and that plan is in full effect. Right? You're moving forward with it. And while you're in the middle of executing on that plan, you don't have time to look back constantly. What have I done? Why is this not work? You don't have time for that because you're too busy looking forward. And if something doesn't pan out, then it's like, okay, so then that didn't work out. Maybe I need to try it this way because I still want to achieve this thing, but that road did not work, so let me try something else. You know, you may, instead of turning right, you may have to turn left in order to meet that particular milestone. But when you are in full swing and moving forward in that particular goal, in that particular plan, you don't have time to look back. But all that to say that in all of that planning and the execution of that plan, you are prepping yourself for the manifestation of your blessings. You want a husband, you want a wife. If you are what? If you are being a slob, not washing dishes, you're not cooking, you're not being mindful of other people, you're not clearing out your closet to make room for that other person's stuff, you know, you're sleeping like a starfish on the bed, you're taking up the whole bed, you're not sleeping on one side of the bed to make room for that other person. You're not emptying out your life. You're not creating that vacuum in your life to make room for that other person. And what do I mean by that? you're so caught up in your friends' problems, in your family's problems, in the work problems, that you don't have room and you don't have time for anything outside of those things. And the thing about that is that people think that, oh no, that I always have time for myself. That's not spending time with yourself. That's spending time, or spending time on your own life. That's spending time on other people's lives. And I people tend to mistake the two. They think just because, yes, that person is in your life, I get it, you know, and they think because they're helping this person, they're working on this person's life, that they're working on their own life, and that's not the case. You working on someone else's life and you working on your own life are two completely, very completely different things. But put people in their place. Put people where they belong in your life. People should not take up your entire life. You need to, and then you wonder why, you know, why can't I, why is it my mate coming? Why can't I find anyone? You don't have time. You don't have the room. Even if you found someone, you would lose them because you don't have the room for them. What do I hear? Well, Tiffany, when that person comes, then I will make room for that person. Well, no, it doesn't work like that. You make room for that person now and create that vacuum so that, suck that person right in, suck that energy right in, but you need to create a vacuum. And creating that vacuum and then preparing yourself for that person, well, these are the things that I would do if that person was here. Perfect. Do those things now. And as you do those things and as you show the universe that you're prepared for your blessing, then your blessing will come. So all that to say, the time between putting what you want out there into the universe and that thing actually manifesting, that's your time and your opportunity to practice for your blessing and to prepare yourself for your blessing. And you will find that your blessing comes much faster and much easier for you when you are practicing, when you are living in that space, right? Fake it till you make it. When you're actually living in that space, because that practice time will also force you to live in that space. And in living in that space, it will align you energetically with exactly what you are wanting. And that's also the purpose of practicing and living in that space, practicing for your opportunity. Okay, it will align you, it will align your energy for that opportunity, for that thing. Until next time, love and light. Bye.